From what our elders tell us, there was a great lacrosse game that was played a long time ago between the animals and birds. All the animals and all the birds showed up to play. The game lasted all day long, and in the end, the animals won. What we are told is that lacrosse game took place before there were even humans. When our ancestors learned how to play the game of lacrosse, they learned to make the sticks using the wood from the ash tree. That game of lacrosse has been played for a very long time.
Ash trees are a beautiful part of the natural communities in the Lower Chippewa River Valley in Wisconsin. According to the Wisconsin DNR, there is an estimated 737 million ash trees in Wisconsin. Their seeds provide food for moth, bird, and mammal species. Other tree and shrub species thrive in the shade created by an ash tree's canopy. The characteristics of ash wood also make it valuable to humans. For generations, Native Americans used black ash wood to make baskets. The white ash, known for its durability and flexibility, is shaped into lacrosse sticks and baseball bats. The ash tree's existence is threatened by a shiny green insect, no bigger than a penny. When emerald ash borer arrives in the Lower Chippewa River Valley, it will greatly alter the land's ecology. Emerald ash borer will rapidly decrease the ash tree population and force species who are dependent on the ash tree to adapt to a new, unfamiliar environment. An invasive species like the emerald ash borer is a non-native species whose introduction does or is likely to cause economic or environmental harm to human health. Following habitat destruction, invasive species are the second leading cause of biodiversity loss around the world. When one strand of the web of life is cut, the unraveling can spread throughout the ecosystem. The net results are a loss of diversity of our native plants and animals as invasive species rapidly multiply and take over. The emerald ash borer is a species native to Asia that was transported to North America by infested wood pallets. The first state it was brought to in the United States was Michigan, and has since been found in the states with the red dots. In Wisconsin, the lumber industry and nurseries, as well as urban landscapes, are impacted negatively by emerald ash borer. According to Poland and McCullough, there is an estimated 8 billion ash trees across the United States that has a compensatory value of $282 billion. Emerald ash borer infestation is estimated to cost $10.7 billion in the next decade in the forms of ash treatment, ash tree removal, and ash tree replacement costs. Ash species in Wisconsin's forest lands grow in a variety of soil and sites. The numerous ecological benefits provided by ash trees are thermal cover, food, and protection for a variety of wildlife species. Abundant seed crops produced in large amounts by the ash tree are consumed by small mammals, birds, and insects. Twigs and leaves provide food for deer and moose, and trunk cavities on the ash tree provide nesting for birds, such as wood ducks, owls, and woodpeckers. The ash is a dominant tree species in some wetland ecosystems. According to the Natural Resource Conservation Service, ash trees are associated with wet soils and floodplains, depressions, and stream bottoms. Green ash is the most widespread ash species and is a dominant layer of foliage in forests and on heavy wet soils, and is especially common along river corridors. Black ash is common in northern Wisconsin in cold, wet areas of the Great Lakes region. White ash is commonly used in urban landscape and is highly prized in making baseball bats. The ash popularity decline and widespread mortality will fundamentally alter the function of wetland ecosystems. This will result in a reduction in availability of a timber resource as well as a valued source of wood for the Native American basketry. Emerald ash borer is 100% fatal to ash trees of any size, any age, stressed, or healthy. It is not the adult beetle that causes the damage to the ash trees, but the larva. The emerald ash borer manual states that the larva causes the most harm by feeding on the inner bark of the ash tree and disrupts the tree's ability to transport water and nutrients, causing the tree to starve and eventually die. Mortality of the ash tree happens within 2 to 4 years of being attacked by emerald ash borer. In the United States, the ash species has no natural resistance to the emerald ash borer. The continued spread of this pest threatens species and wildlife and may permanently alter landscape ecosystems of the Midwest. What will grow in place of the ash trees? Another type of tree? Or will a new invasive species be introduced to the land? The species that thrive off the ash tree will have to adapt to the new change of the region. The spread of emerald ash borer and the resulting death of thousands of ash trees is inevitable. It will happen. We can, however, slow that spread by educating people about how humans perpetuate this problem. Firewood is one of the major mediums through which the larva of emerald ash borer is spread from place to place. If you go camping, use firewood that you find at your campsite. Do not bring wood from home or purchase any on the side of the road. we need to stop moving ash wood materials between states. Many governmental agencies ban the transport of firewood onto public lands. Also, learn how to identify the beetle and the marks that it leaves behind. If you suspect emerald ash borers in your area, contact your local DNR. The only treatment we have right now is education and awareness to slow the spread, in order to buy more time for research and possible treatment options.
Please don't move firewood.
Please don't move firewood.
Don't move firewood.
Gego is you be do, kegun, iu mishi, indo da minomin baga duewin.